After New York, do you get to go home?
Yeah, I'm going to go home. And who knows what? Who knows? Maybe I'll really quit for real now. Just end on a high when people are least expecting it.
Hannah Gadsby's here, everybody.
Woo! Woo.
Hi. How you doing?
We don't have to introduce you because the world pretty much knows who you are.
There'll come a time.
Yeah.
When I do need an introduction.
But they have a new special called Something Special, streaming on Netflix right now. Congratulations. Mm-hmm.
Thank
very
you very
funny.
Much. Oh, yeah. You've seen it.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah.
Good job.
We get preview content.
Your set was really cool.
The literal set.
Yeah.
Yeah, wasn't
it? The actual
it?
Set. Yeah, the set. It was very, it was like a forest.
Yeah, and it smelled that way. So we had actual live plants in there and sort of moss put over logs, which is
oh, wow.
How long did you tour it before you shot it?
Oh, 18 months.
Really?
Mm. And it was hell. Like, it's a feel-good show,
yeah.
But the tour was bad.
Why?
Oh, it was okay. Like, that was extreme, wasn't it? But I going into the first out of the tours, I had just had a total knee reconstruction. 6 months later, I broke my leg in two places. So then I was in a wheelchair with
what?
Pins and screws and just... And the world's not accessible. We knew this in theory, but I found out in practice.
Oh, my God. Man. How'd you break your leg?
I slipped on ice. In Iceland.
In Iceland, yeah.
Writes itself.
Yeah, right, exactly.
But like that was like, you were telling me about, it was gnarly. Like you had to, like, not an easy place to get to you.
No, it's a little, on a fjord. At low tide, there's a land bridge to an island.
Uh-huh.
The Airbnb we were staying at, it was just before we was to start the European tour, they said, you should walk to this island. And so we did. And then my wife went up to and had a look at the views. And I said, you know what, I'm going to play it safe and just do the perimeter.
Uh-huh.
And then I slipped doing it safe. And just, you know, my foot cracked. But then I was on ice, so it kept going and it broke again. And then, you know, it's Iceland in January.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's getting dark very quickly and the tide's rising. So I can't move. And poor old Jenna's just run away. We rang up the Airbnb host and they're like, we're in Spain.
Oh, and no.
Oh, wow.
So she, yeah, well, I got rescued. I did give up. Like, I thought, well, this is where I'm going to die.
Oh,
because
no.
I wasn't going to move. It, you know, I could have been heroic, but I made a decision not to be.
Just to give in.
You're like, this is it.
Right? It was like, I would have had to army crawl back against a rising tide over really sharp rocks.
Oh, my God.
And I thought, you know what? I'll die.
Were you okay with that?
Yeah, I made peace.
Yeah.
Yeah, very quickly. It's very nice there, very quiet.
Right.
Yeah.
You're like, I've accomplished a lot.
Yeah.
Right? Did it.
What a way to go out.
Yeah.
But I got rescued. So, spoiler alert.
I'm alive.
So these couple of guys in trucks came and they built a splint out of ratchet straps and a spirit level, and then load me in the back of the truck.
Oh,
drove for a couple
God.
Of hours to
oh
a hospital.
My gosh,
couple of hours.
Yeah, not the main hospital on the island.
Oh,
and then they're like, oh, well, we can't help you. So they reset. They put me under and broke the leg back into place. And then I had, I don't know why I remember this detail, but a blue Powerade and a ham and cheese sandwich.
The only comfort in the story.
It was really nice.
Yeah.
And then I went, they got an ambulance into Reykjavik the next day and they fixed it. Free healthcare, and I never met the surgeon. His name was Thor. It was a good break to have in Iceland. It's one that's quite common.
Uh-huh.
It's one the surgeon's done a million times before.
That was lucky.
Because people are falling on the ice all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a thing. I mean,
man.
They lead with it.
Yeah.
Ice. Man, but does anyone listen? No.
Man, I slipped on the ice in North Dakota and walking to a show. I was by myself.
Same amount of danger.
And it was, but I couldn't get over how quick. Like, you don't, it's not like, oh, I think I'm falling. It's just, you're walking and all of a sudden, and you're down.
Yes, yeah. You don't have time to catch up.
Nothing. Mm-hmm. It's so fast.
Well, the one bright spot was you got married. That's
very
exciting.
It is.
Congratulations.
It really pushed that in sickness.
Yeah, for sure.
We'll see how she goes in health. But she's definitely stuck with me in sickness.
Yeah. Well, that's a good way to test it. Mm. Start there and, you know, hopefully yeah. it's all better from
and
here.
And the set design that you so admired was Jenno's work.
That was, said, yeah. yeah.
Also directed the special. We hang out a lot, so we're just really...
how my wife and I are, yeah, too. Yeah. yeah,
basically a double act.
I didn't realize she directed it.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah. She's got skills.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's holding this. She's holding. If it was just up to me, this would have died in Iceland.
Where you gave up.
I gave up. She has executive function and she understands how time works, and that's a real game changer for me. Yeah. It's like, I'm here. Yeah. Time. Welcome.
Y'all compliment each yeah. other.
It was funny when you were talking about during the pandemic that you were fine with it. Like, with your autism, and you're like, this is, I don't really need other people right now. But then you noticed your partner's kind of freaking out.
Well, not so much freaking out, but she was talking to the dogs. And
the one part that made me laugh, especially about this interview, was when you were talking about that maybe it's because of being autistic that friendly people kind of freak you out a little bit. And I was like, you come in and Fortune and I are like, hey! We're like trying to tone it down a little bit.
Well, I understand that when you got headphones on and a microphone that you're on, we're on. This is a performance of sorts. Right. It's just when people are like that all the time, I'm taken aback. Like, you don't have to be happy right now. Why? Why this performance? What are you doing?
It's exhausting.
Yeah, it is. I don't know how people do it.
Do you find that more in the States than you do?
Yeah. Absolutely. We don't care in Australia. Like, we do, but it's really understated. It's a...
Right.
I mean, it's there in our foundation myths, isn't it? We were convicts, and you really thought you were God's gift to Earth. In the right. Like, in the white foundation of American Australia. So we have low self-esteem.
Do you find that a lot of people, especially in LA, try to hug?
Oh, I'm before I come here, I practice being dead inside and just go with it. Like,